Hello learner, greetings of the day. Welcome to my video lecture on computer networks and security. In this video, I'll be discussing about security methods and what is cryptography, its types, and I'll be also discussing symmetric key cryptography with the two algorithms under symmetric key cryptography. They are data encryption standard and advanced encryption standard. Till now we have seen different types of attacks to the computer networks and the data. Now we will see what are the different security methods are there to prevent those type of attacks. The common solution that can protect computer communication networks from attacks are classified as cryptographic techniques and authentication techniques. Cryptographic techniques are to provide confidentiality to the data, and authentication techniques are used to verify the sender. That means to authenticate the sender. Cryptography. The definition of the cryptography says that it is the process of transforming a piece of information or a message shared by two parties into some sort of code. We will discuss this with an example diagram or a block diagram. Here I consider a message, whatever we call it as plain text. Now if at all we transfer the plain text as it is through insecure network, that plain text can be accessed by any intruder or unauthorized party, and he can access the message and he can read it. So in order to secure this plain text or message, we have to convert this message to some sort of code. That process of converting a plain text to a cipher text, that is a code, sort of code, is called as encryption. I say once again, the process of converting a plain text to cipher text is called as encryption. So this encryption happens at the sender side. Now the encrypted message is called as cipher text. This cipher text will be transferred through the insecure network. Even though the intruder tries to access the message, he cannot understand what exactly the message is. That is how we can provide security for the data or the message, whatever the sender is transforming to the receiver. In order to encrypt any message, it uses a key which is called as encryption key. It is nothing but a number which will be used along with the encryption process. Now at the receiver side, the ciphertext will be received by the receiver. This ciphertext need to be converted back to plain text in order to receiver read the message correctly. Now the process of converting ciphertext back to plain text is called as decryption. Again, this process, decryption process, will be using a key which is called as decryption key. So we can say that decryption happens at the receiver side. The whole process of encryption and decryption, we can call it as cryptography. The encryption can happen at two different phases. One is end-to-end encryption, which is done at sender and the receiver, and link encryption, which will be done at each link. In computer communication networks, data can travel between two users while it is encrypted. In the given diagram, two servers are exchanging data while two types of encryption devices are installed in their communication network. The first encryption device is end-to-end encryption, whereby secret coding is carried out at both end system. In this diagram, server A encodes its data, which can be decoded only at the other end of the server. The second phase of encryption is link encryption, which secures all the traffic passing over the link. Based upon the keys used for encryption and decryption, cryptographic techniques can be broadly classified into three types. First is called as symmetric key cryptography, which is also called as private key encryption. In this, both sender and receiver will be using same key for encryption and decryption process. The second one is asymmetric key cryptography, which is also called as public key encryption, where sender and receiver will be utilizing two different keys for encryption and decryption purpose. The third cryptographic technique is called as hash functions. Here, no key will be utilized for encryption and decryption, where a message hash value will be calculated based upon the input message. What is symmetric key cryptography? As I told, it is an encryption system where the sender and receiver of message use a single common key to encrypt and decrypt the message. Some of the well-known algorithms for symmetric key cryptography are DES and AES. These are the two types of algorithms which comes under symmetric key cryptography. We have the block diagram of symmetric key cryptography. We have a plain text. This plain text will be converted into ciphertext, which is called as encryption process by using a secret key at the sender side. And at the receiver side, ciphertext will be converted back to plain text using the decryption process by using the same key whatever sender side has used for encryption. Since sender and receiver uses same key, this type of cryptography is called as symmetric key cryptography. Symmetric means same. Next is asymmetric key cryptography. Under this system, a pair of keys is used to encrypt and decrypt the information. That means sender and receiver will be using different keys for encryption and decryption. The sender side will be using a public key for encryption, and receiver side will be using private key for decryption. Public key and private keys are different. So the name is asymmetric. Asymmetric means different. A well-known algorithm which comes under this asymmetric key cryptography is RSA algorithm, which is our topic of discussion. As it is shown in the diagram, here we convert plain text to ciphertext using a encryption, using a public key at the sender side, and ciphertext will be converted back to plain text by using a secret key, which is called as private key, which is different from the sender side key. After looking into two different types of cryptographic techniques, we can summarize secret key encryption and public key encryption as: secret key encryption uses same key at sender side and receiver side for encryption and decryption, and public key crypto system uses two different keys for sender to encrypt and to receiver to decrypt the the ciphertext. Public key crypto system is more powerful than secret key encryption, and it provides better security and message privacy. One drawback of public key encryption is the speed is less, since it includes more complex computation. And it may not be more practical in many cases. Encryption methods offer the assurance of message confidentiality. That means the encryption techniques, whatever we have discussed, that is cryptography, ensures that the message confidentiality is maintained. However, a networking system must be able to verify the authenticity of the message and the sender of the message. These forms of security techniques in computer networks are known as authentication techniques and are categorized as authentication with message digest and authentication with digital signature. These are the two techniques we have to authenticate the message as well as the sender. Message authentication protects a user in a network against data falsification and ensures data integrity. These methods do not necessarily use keys. Now we will see some of the familiar secret key encryption protocols. Secret key encryption protocols are also called as symmetric encryption or single key encryption protocol, or sometimes it's also called as conventional encryption models. All these names are synonyms for secret key encryption protocols. We have three important protocols or algorithms under secret key encryption protocol. The first is data encryption standard. Second one is advanced encryption standard. And third is triple DES. These are the three important symmetric block ciphers. Since these are symmetric encryption standards, in these algorithms, both sender and receiver will be using same key for encryption as well as decryption process. The first algorithm is data encryption standard or DES. This is also called as data encryption algorithm. The DES algorithm is a symmetric key block cipher created in the early 1970s by an IBM team. Why DES is called as block ciphers? There are different types of ciphers. One is stream cipher and block cipher. Block cipher will encrypt a block of text, a group of text, whereas stream cipher will convert encrypt bit by bit. That is the main difference between block cipher and stream cipher. DES is an example for block ciphers. And it is a symmetric key block cipher. What is symmetric? Symmetric means same. Since both sender and receiver uses same key for encryption and decryption, it is called as symmetric key. So altogether we can say that DES is a symmetric key block cipher. And this particular DES adopted by National Institute of Standards and Technology, NIST. And if you see the block diagram of DES, it is based upon the Feistel block cipher, which is called as Lucifer, which is developed by one of the researcher, cryptography researcher, called as Horst Feistel in 1971 at IBM lab. So these are some of the history of DES. Next, we will see how exactly DES algorithm works for encrypting and decrypting the data. If you consider DES algorithm, we consider 64-bit length of plain text. Since it is a block cipher, it takes one block as 64 bits. And it uses 56-bit length of key for encryption as well as decryption. And there will be 16 rounds of processing in order to encrypt and decrypting the plain text or ciphertext. And if you consider decryption process, it is exactly the same as encryption process. Only the input differs. For encryption, we input plain text, and for decryption, we input ciphertext. So the important part here is plain text length, that is 64 bit, and key length is 56 bits, and number of rounds is 16. So these are the basic description of DES algorithm. As the initial step of DES algorithm, the entire 64 bit message and 56 bits of secret key are separately permuted. That means they will be shuffled to give an input for the first round. Once we shuffle the 64 bit message, it will be broken into two halves, each having 32 bit, and they will be denoted by LI and RI, where I denotes the round number, which goes from 1 to 16. The 56 bits of key are also broken into two halves, each having 28 bit, and each half is rotated 1 or 2 bit positions depending upon the round. Once we rotate the bits, we get a new version of key, which is called as KI, where I is again the round number. Once we have all these things, we can generalize the LI and RI as LI is equal to RI minus 1 and RI is equal to LI minus 1 XOR, the function between RI minus 1 and the key for the particular round, that is KI. Again, the output of LI and RI is nothing but 32 bit, and they will be combined into 64 bit. Again, that will be permuted. So this is the step we carry out for single round. So these things will be repeated 16 times. So that means the output of one round will be given as an input for the next round. We will explain with a feature structure. Now, what exactly happens in this particular function? So we use key only with this function. So we'll see what exactly we do as a function. The operation of function at any round I of DES is as follows. Even though we have 56 bit of key, in the function we choose only 48 bits out of 56 bit. Once we have 48 bit of key, we need to convert 32 bit of RI minus 1 into 48 bits. So that is why we expand 32 bit of data into 48 bit of data. Once we have 48 bit key and 48 bit data, we perform the XOR operation as given by RI minus 1 is equal to RI minus 1 XOR KI, where K is the key and RI is the data, 48 bit of data and 48 bit of key. So this will be performed as a function in each round. This is the feature structure of DES algorithm. As we have seen in the algorithm, 64 bit of plain text is given as an input, and it will be initially permuted, it will be shuffled, and it will be divided into two halves, LI and RI, each having 32 bit. So this is L part, that is left part and right part, and these things will be given as an input for the first round. So this is the first round. So if you consider the first round, the R1 is 32 bit is given as input for the function. So this is where we perform the function operation. And if you consider L2, L2 is nothing but R1, that is RI minus 1. And if you consider R2, so that is nothing but L1 XOR the output of this function. So we can generalize this particular output of one round as LI is equal to RI minus 1. If you consider the first round, we will have L2 is equal to R1. And if you consider R2, that is ri is equal to li minus 1 xor the output of the function, that is inside the function we perform xor between ri minus 1 and the ki. So if you consider r2, so that is nothing but l1 xor the output of the function between r1 and q1. Again, if you consider key here, 56 bit key is again, it will be shuffled in the initial round, and this 56 bit key will be given as an input, and here we divide into two half of having a 28 bit, and these things will be rotated, and once we rotate we will be getting the again 56 bit key that will be again permuted, which will have a key called as k1. So once we do for each round, we will be getting different key, so that is why key goes from k1 to k16. And out of this 56, the function chooses only 48 bit key, and this 32 bit will be expanded to 48 bit. So what exactly we do inside this function is nothing but ri minus 1 is equal to ri minus 1 xor ki. So here we take only 48 bit of key and we convert 32 bit data into 48 bit data, and that's output. This output will be xored with the xored with li minus 1. So that output will be given to this permutation. So again it will be shuffled, that is permuted, and that will be taken as the output, that is R2. So that is why, so this is nothing but the entire this particular equation. And this function we perform here. So this will be repeated for 16 times. The output of 16th round is nothing but the ciphertext, 64 bit ciphertext. Now this is the process for encryption. For decryption, the same process will be performed, again 16 rounds of process, but input will be ciphertext and the output of 16th round will be the plain text. And it is known that whenever we implement DES in hardware, it will have more efficient than the software implementation. And later it is seen that the security level whatever DES has given is not that much strong enough, that the strongness or the strength of the security depends upon the number of bits in the key. So that is why the DES is again extended to triple DES, where we implement the DES operation thrice and we use 168 length of key instead of 56 bit key. Triple DES uses 168 bit of key length. So this is all about DES algorithm. The next algorithm is Advanced Encryption Standard. In short, we call it as AES. The Advanced Encryption Standard protocol has a better security strength than DES. AES supports 128 bit symmetric block message and it uses 128, 192 or 256 bit keys. Here we use different length of keys, either 128 bit or 192 bit or 256 bit. So this depends upon the number of rounds which we perform in AES algorithm. The number of rounds in AES is variable from 10, 12 and 14. So either we can choose 10 rounds or we can choose 12 or we can also choose 14. If you choose 10 rounds, then we will be using 128 bit key. If we choose 12 rounds, then we will have 192 bit length key. And if you choose 14 rounds, then we will have 256 bit key. But the length of the message or symmetric block does not change. It remains the 128 bit. Only the length of the key changes with respect to number of rounds. and each round will include four steps. That is, first is substitution, second is permutation, and third is mixing the columns. And this we have only in the all the rounds except last round, and the last round is AND round key. So these are the four steps we have in AES algorithm. So this we will see in the feature structure of AES algorithm. This is the feature structure of AES algorithm. A single block of 128-bit plain text, which is of 16 bytes from M0 to M15, is given as an input for initial stage. So 16 bytes makes it 128-bit. The plain text is formed as 16 byte, that is M0 to M15 as given in the diagram. And it is fed into the round 1 after initialization stage. In this round, substitute units indicated by letter S is performed a byte by byte substitution of blocks. The ciphers in the form of rows and columns move through the permutation stage to shift rows and to mix columns. At the end of this round, all 16 blocks of ciphers are XORed with 16 byte of round 1 key. That means K0 to K15. The 128-bit key is expanded for 10 rounds, and AES decryption algorithm is fairly simple and is basically the reverse of encryption algorithm at each stage of a round. And all stages of each round are reversible. So here, once we complete 10 rounds, the output will be the of ciphertext. And here you can see here, the mix column is only for first 9 rounds, if at all we have 10 rounds, and last round we don't have mix column operation. So this is how advanced encryption standard works for getting ciphertext from plain text. Thank you for watching the video. We'll meet in the next video.